County, copy possible power lines down. Eyes on the vegetation fire, it's underneath the transmission lines. Have about a 35 mile an hour sustained wind on it.
My pops have been in Concow ever since I can remember, before I was born. It's always felt so special. It's at the end of Concow Road, and like the top, we always felt like nothing could hurt us there, and it was home sweet home. He'd grow pumpkins for the grandkids, so in October, when they were ready to harvest, we'd have jack-o'-lanterns to carve, and they were Papa's pumpkins, and they were bigger than anyone's you'd seen. My pops lost his leg in a farming incident, but they're stubborn mountain folk. He was always outside working when we showed up, out in his wheelchair working away. He was out there in his wheelchair with a hose, putting out the fires that were breaking out into his yard. And my dad was like, you know, don't worry about it. You need to go. We need to get out of here and leave. And he said, okay, I will. I'll grab the dogs and I'll go.
We need to shut down Highway 70 and then stand by for additional resource order.
Sirens or warnings or anything. No one telling anyone for sure what was happening, so we're like, oh, let's go check it out. We just get in the car and we can't even pull out because there was cars all the way down. You couldn't even get on the road.
Oh, there's a power line in the road.
Everything was red. Everything just seemed like panic.
I feel the heat, dude.
Literally so scared. I really want to make it. I started freaking out because the fire's coming at us and I didn't want to see it. I didn't want to feel it. Like, I didn't want to be there. I just kind of wanted to disappear because I couldn't believe this was happening.
Holy.
It was suffering moving that slow. Like, I didn't understand why not everyone was flooring it. Like, we were all about to burn alive. Like, why is it everyone, like, full speed ahead? Like, why are we stuck? Like, why? How? There was literally a point on the road where it went from hell to there was a sky again, and there was air to breathe, and it was this type of feeling that changes your whole entire life. I just got this chance to be able to live again. we never gave up hope. You know, we kept looking, and he can't read or write, so we thought maybe he couldn't get in contact with us. Say it was 2 weeks later, my mom called me, and she was all like, Jordan, I knew what the phone call was because, like, my mom doesn't call to talk. And she told me they found Bob's body. And I was like, yeah. And they're like, yeah, they found that body in the home. And I was like, oh. And, you know, I just cried. I didn't know what to say. And she asked me if I'm okay. And I just hung up the phone because you're not okay. We went out there on December 4th, me and my dad only. Literally everything is gone except, you know, you go out to the back fence and you see a wheelchair. You see his watering hose burnt to a crisp, all the way dragged, all the way right next to the wheelchair in a bucket of water. Your mind, like, wants to make an image, but you don't really want to make an image, but it does it anyways. And man, is it crazy to have an image like that in your head. He was insanely tough and smart, and he was a gentle giant.
An existential crisis that is already taking lives and livelihoods for countless people all around the world.